This is my favorite meeting of our year. We have no business to do other than to celebrate and recognize the young people in front of us who have accomplished something extraordinary. And so tonight is all about you. It's a celebration, and we look forward to seeing you and hearing from you about what your experience is like and what you're looking to do next. So with that, I'm going to pass it to Jane.
Good afternoon. I'm Jane Belmore. I'm the interim superintendent this year. I'm very happy to be with you this year, and I'm happy to be here tonight to celebrate with you. I'd like to welcome students, families, and staff, and to thank you all for being here. We're very honored to have you join us for this important tradition. Tonight, we have the pleasure of recognizing the 41 students in our district who have achieved semifinalist status in the National Merit Scholarship Competition. Congratulations to each of you in this audience on this prestigious achievement, because it is an achievement that you all have played a part in, but especially for our students who have worked so hard. Before we hear from some of our students and present awards, I'd like to introduce Michael Hernandez. Michael is our new chief of schools for high schools this year, former principal of East High School. Some of you may know him. Michael oversees our high schools and will give us an overview of the National Merit Program. So, Michael, would you?
So, thank you. I'm honored to be here today to see and to celebrate these scholars that are sitting in front of me today. I want to truly thank you for your hard work, as well as to thank the parents, the guardians, the teachers, the staff that are here as well to celebrate you. The mission of the National Merit Scholarship Corporation is to recognize and honor the academically talented students of the United States. The National Merit Scholarship Corporation accomplishes this mission by conducting nationwide academic scholarship programs. The enduring goals of this scholarship programs are to promote a wider and deeper respect for learning in general and for exceptionally talented individuals, to shine a spotlight on brilliant students and encourage the pursuit of academic excellence at all levels of education, to stimulate increased support from organizations that wish to sponsor scholarships for these outstanding academic talents. After reaching the stage, these talented high school seniors now have the opportunity to compete for the National Merit Scholarships to be awarded this spring. Currently, there's approximately 16,000 National Merit semifinalists throughout the country. We are fortunate to have 41 in our school district. That means that you are the top 1% of all students in this nation right now, and that deserves a round of applause. We know how hard you've worked. You've set yourself as role models. You participate in extracurricular activities. You might be the role models that you don't really understand how much you influence your peers as well as the youth. We understand the pressures that are put on top of you as well. You've challenged yourselves academically, and you participate in the athletics and the extracurriculars and internships around this community. And for that, we again thank you for that commitment. To each of the scholars tonight, I want to remind you, this is the beginning. You have a lot of work ahead of you as you are going on through college. The hard work you've invested in your high school education will take you far, and your efforts and your drive will create a strong platform for the next phase. You have already demonstrated that you're ready to chart your course, but because you've worked so hard, now the hard work is turning into passion. Remember, part of this event is to celebrate you, because this gift that you have received over the last 12 years is partly because of the adults that are in this room and the teachers that you walked away at the end of the day today. So my hope is that when we're done, you're shaking each other's hands, but then you're giving hugs to your parents, to your guardians, and the teachers as well. Families, congratulations. We know that this has been hard work. Hard work to support these young scholars and all the draws and pulls that our teenagers face today. We applaud and we appreciate your work as well. Now is the time that we're going to hear from some students. We've asked a few students from each school to come up and make some brief remarks, recognizing a person or persons who have positively impacted their education. We ask these students to come up to this microphone in the order that you've been called. Before we start, can I have Ethan Dong, Julie Zoe, and Grace Petruska to come up to the podium, please.
I don't know. Go ask Nick was the defining quote of our robotics team and one that we've shared endless laughs on. Nick Fouts, a leader and mentor on our robotics team, BadgerBots, has always been a person of few but precious words. And I began to find out what those words were once I worked up the courage to talk. It all started from me asking him where the files were after someone instructed me to round off a piece we had built. And it had been grown. It has grown to be Nick sometimes acting as our own makeshift clamp, holding our robot down as our team frantically attached the mechanical arm minutes before we had to bag it up on our stop build day. This dedication he shows through his flawless attendance at our meetings has inspired my growth as a student and as a learner. When I joined BadgerBots, the idea that I might one day build a 100 plus pound robot to participate in some competition blew me away. It simply seemed impossible for someone like me. I motivated myself to achieve, but even with my drive, I found out how difficult it was to succeed alone. Yet, each time, without fail, I knew who to go to. Nick. Without Nick, I would have long been disheartened as to why my 10th try at cutting a piece wasn't working, or why 2 hours of pouring frustration still hadn't resolved the discrepancies that arose only when we began to assemble the robot. I can always remember that one long night at one of our regional competitions where a group of us students were awake and planning all the way past 1 a.m. I knew I wanted to be in that discussion. I knew I wanted our team to have the best shot. So I stayed up to crunch the numbers and predict the matchups. But it puzzled me because I always look across the circle and see Nick, mirroring my own attention and eagerness. The rest of the students soon began to droop their heads, but Nick was determined to continue. Granted, pure caffeine doesn't run through our veins like it does Nick's, but I began to realize he embodied what I wanted to be. I didn't think of it then, but his dedication to the program, to our team, and to all of our students has been so crucial for me to realize what I want to be able to do and accomplish when I grow up myself. The experience and the expertise that Nick brings to every problem and every solution never fails to leave me in awe. It's his own superpower, to be quite honest. And to be honest, that's something I've always swooned over having. Striving for that dream has led me to learn more than I thought I was capable of, and to exhibit even more than where I thought my potential limited me. As a person too, Nick has shown me what it means to be a leader, to lead by example, and to always be there for those eager to learn. I only hope that one day I can be that person for someone else too, the one they can look up to, can inspire to be like, but more importantly, someone that they can go to with any questions and always expect a comforting answer. Everything Nick has been for me and has shown me has not only revamped my outlook on my future, but has also gone hand in hand with everything MMSD has provided my peers and I. These advanced avenues and new doorways built the foundation for my intellectual curiosity that I will take with myself after high school. I would also like to thank my counselor, Ms. Enderly, for always being eager to help me pursue the next step I sought, and always willing to answer my miscellaneous questions. All my teachers, especially Mr. Getchest and Mr. Nepper, have been there through my few short years to lead my pursuit of education and foster a love of learning in me by always being ready to help, despite already having put up with us rambunctious teenagers for 7 hours a day. Finally, my parents. They have been my oldest supporters, quite obviously, through everything. The success, the failures, and through it all, they still continue to motivate me to strive for the best, providing me with every opportunity that they can and supporting me in every activity that I love. This day commemorates our success as students, but without everyone around us, none of us would be here. So thank you to all those that have made this part of our journeys possible.
Julia, can you come up?
Hello, everyone. My name is Julia Zoe, and I attend Memorial High School. To begin, I would like to recognize all of the other outstanding students and congratulate them on their achievements. I am honored to be with such talented individuals who I know will make a positive impact on the world. We are here because of all of our hard work, determination, and motivation. But we are also here because of all of the supporting figures that surround us. Thank you to all of the teachers, family members, counselors, coaches, principals, and more for guiding us through our high school journeys and tolerating our craziness. There are so many different people I would like to thank, for I would not be standing on this stage if it weren't for any of them. But tonight, I'd like to dedicate this speech to two different people. First, my counselor, Mr. Stendahl. Thank you for being someone who I could always confide in. Without you, I would have been so lost in high school. You were always there to answer my questions, help me when I was struggling, and you always give the best advice. You've taught me how to be more confident in myself and to be proud of all of my accomplishments. The amount you care about other people, even if you don't know them, is truly heartwarming. If everyone in the world could be like you, we would have no problems. Your kind heart has inspired me to become someone who helps others, whether that's becoming a scientist who contributes to discovering a cure or a doctor who utilizes new developments to treat patients. Despite your incredibly busy schedule, you always find time for me, and for that, I am truly grateful. I would also like to thank my mom, who has always been there for me. She came to cheer me on during all of my tennis matches, drove me to all of my piano and violin lessons, stayed up late with me while I finished my homework, and taught me how to be a caring and thoughtful person. My mom is one of the strongest, most hardworking, intelligent people I know. She encouraged me to pave my own path and become a scientist, even if no one else in the family has done so, because that's my passion. She supported me throughout all of the ups and downs in my life and taught me how to persevere. Her strong work ethic has influenced me in so many ways, and I know that because of her, I will survive the long process of earning an MD or PhD. Thank you for everything you've done for me, Mom. Congratulations again to everyone. Thank you.
Grace.
Hi, everyone. My name is Grace Petrushka, and I'm a senior at Madison East High School. I want to thank the Board of Education, my teachers, and school administrators for being offered this opportunity. With my parents' continued support and the way they've taught me and my siblings the life lessons, values, to be respectful, kind, determined, and strong, have made me the person I am today, and has given me the basis to embrace changes, successes, and even failures. The success I've had in high school is attributed to the conviction and dedication of all my teachers, beginning way back to the elementary school level. Being able to navigate through the ebbs and flows of my high school career has only been possible by the wonderful teachers I've had at East. One in particular that I would like to highlight is our interim principal, Mr. Carney. Looking back at my 4 years of high school, he has always been gratefully impactful and influential to my life. When I first met Mr. Carney my freshman year, he was the new AVID teacher at East. He not only taught me how important it is to be organized and ready for anything, but he has also been one of my biggest supporters and has given me life advice that I still live by to this day. Watching Mr. Carney himself grow through my 4 years of high school, from AVID teacher to school principal, has inspired me to be dedicated to achieving my goals and pushing myself to step out of my comfort zone. My education through MMSD and East High School has also given me the confidence to believe I can do anything through dedication and hard work, and has given us a community that celebrates, accepts, and influences each other's differences. I have been given chances to embrace challenges and take risks while still having high expectations for myself and the grit to reach all of my goals. I plan to further my education at the University of Wisconsin-Madison as a Badger and create change to better myself and the impact the community around me. I am proud to be a National Merit Scholar semifinalist. This is a springboard to all that life will have in store for us. Congratulations to us all for this great achievement.
All right, so now it's going to be time for awarding the certificates. I'm going to ask the students to line up along that wall in alphabetical order. Hold on before you move. You're going to be in alphabetical order, and then you are going to come up here, and you will announce your name, and then you will announce who accompanied you today. There'll be a line right here. You guys want to start making the line. There'll be a line here. They'll be shaking hands. If anybody would like to take a picture, that's the time that you're going to be able to come up and take a picture as they finish off. Okay? Scholars, do you have any questions? All right. We're going to line up in alphabetical order, please. All right, scholars, I forgot one thing. When you come up and you say your name and you thank who's with you, you can also say where you are going to go to college at. If it's undecided, that's okay. But it is an opportunity that you can do this. Sarah, do you want to come up?
My name is Cyrus Buerlin.
One more time.
My name is Cyrus Buerlin. I'm here with my mom, Alex, my dad, Kurt, and my brother, Teddy. And as of right now, I'm planning to major in physics in college.
My name is Teddy Buerlin. I am here with my mom, Alex, my father, Kurt, and my brother, Cyrus. And I am planning to major in environmental science and sustainability in college.
My name is Rebecca Cutforth. I'm from Memorial. I plan to study biology and political science, and I'm here today with my mom, Chris, and my dad, Larry.
My name is Charlie Deck. I'm here with my mom and dad, Kate and Francis, and I plan to study music in college.
My name is Ethan Dong. I go to West High School. I'm here today with my mom, Hung Mei, my dad, Hai Chen, and my mentor for my robotics team, Nick Fouts. I plan on studying some sort of computer engineering or biomechatronics in college.
I'm Gavin Frings from West High School. I'm here with my parents, Gary and Sarah, and my grandmother, Small, and I plan on studying engineering.
My name's Owen Jensen. I go to Madison East High School. I'm here tonight with my mom, Martha, and I haven't decided on a specific major yet, but I'm planning on studying something in the STEM field.
Hi, my name is Lizzie Kunkel. I go to Memorial High School. I am here tonight with my parents, Gary and Sarah, my grandparents, Jim and Alice, and my sister, Emily. Next year, I plan to study psychology.
My name is Hannah Lee. I go to Memorial High School. I'm here today with my mom, Lee, and my dad, Jing Shen, and I plan to study biomedical engineering.
My name is Kevin Lee. I go to Madison Memorial High School. I'm here today with my dad, Chi, and I plan to major in computer science.
Wow.
My name is Olivia Lidke. I'm here today with my mom, Nicole, my stepdad, Dirk, my dad, Mike, and my stepmom, Autumn. I attend Memorial High School, and I am currently considering a career in the health sciences.
Hi, my name is Mira Manoharan. I go to Memorial High School. I'm here with my dad, Mano, and my mom, Kavita, and I plan to major in environmental engineering.
Hi, my name is John Merrick. I go to West High School. I'm here with my mom, Jennifer, my dad, Matthew, and my sister, Lucy, and I plan to study either physics or applied math after I graduate.
Hi, my name is Grace Petrushka. I'm here with my grandparents, Bev and Tom, my siblings, Klinkler and Tessa, my parents, Paul and Chris, and my boyfriend, Walter.
Hi, I'm Simon Pioli Dunham. I'm here with my dad, Mark, and I plan to study genetics at UW.
Hey. My name is Joshua Puglielli, and I'm here with my dad, Dave, my mom, Darby, and my grandma, Leanne. And, oh yeah, I go to East High School, and my post-secondary plans are undecided at this moment.
Hi, I'm Rachel. I go to West. I'm here with my mom, Rita, and I plan to study chemistry.
Hi, my name is Olivia Siebert. I go to East. I'm here with my mom, Sarah, and I hope to major in environmental studies and political science.
Hi, I'm Sam Stryker. I go to West High. I'm here with my mom, Laura, and my dad, Rob, and I plan to study education at UW.
Hi, my name is Edwin Upham. I'm here with my mom, Rebecca, and my brother, John. I go to West High School, and I plan to go into aerospace engineering.
My name is Stephen Wilkie. I go to West. I'm here with my mom, Lee, and my dad, Nathan. And in college, I plan to study violin performance and economics.
My name is Tian Xiaoyan. I'm here with my uncle, Tong Haiyan. Wait, where is he? I go to Memorial, and I plan to study in history and sociology.
Hi, my name is Julia Zhou. I attend Memorial High School. I'm here with my mom, Lan, tonight, and I plan on studying molecular, cellular, and developmental biology.
Are there any scholars that arrived a little bit late that did not come up, sit in the front row? All right. Can we give our scholars one more round of applause?
That was very wonderful. Thank you for doing such a great job so that we can have this moment of appreciation for you. Thank you again for being here tonight. And again, congratulations to all of you wonderful students on this achievement. Let's hear it one more time for them. And now, if you would, join us in the staff lounge for some light refreshments and some time to have conversation with each other. Thank you for coming.